Tell your other friends to join immediately so that we can start our lecture. Everyone, please tell your other friends to join immediately so that we can start our lecture without wasting our time. Just 33. Tell your other friends to join immediately. Hello, everyone. we are not going to waste the time. So let's begin our lecture. In the previous lecture, we have started with the part that is cross-sectional elements of the particular highway. The cross-sectional elements, which includes your camber, curb, shoulder, mediation, that is your mediator, and other parts. So in the previous lecture, we have begun with the camber or the cross slope. Okay. Now, what is camber or the cross slope? Once again, we will revise some part of this till other students will join, I hope. So cross slope and camber is the slope provided to the road surface in the transverse direction to drain off the rainwater from the road surface. So whatever the water which is coming on the road surface, to drain out that particular water, we require the slope which helps us to drain out that particular water which is coming on the road surface. It may be your rainwater or it may be of any kind of water. Drainage and disposal of water from the pavement is considered important because of the following reasons. Now, why this particular drainage is important? Because that will affect the stability, surface condition, and durability of the pavement. That is the first reason. As I said earlier in my previous lecture, our road surface conditions are always determined using PSI concept, that is present serviceability index or pavement serviceability index, starting from 0 to 5. And in the present serviceability index, we are always going to focus on the drainage conditions which are present over there. Once again, I am reminding for everyone, if water is get drained out within an hour on any particular track, the drainage conditions are the best one, so that we can that will help us to rate that road or to predict the serviceability for that particular roads. Okay. So if the road is water is going to be drained out within an hour, the drainage conditions are extremely good. If the water is going to get drained out within 24 hours, the drainage conditions are good. If the water is going to be drained out within an week, the drainage conditions are fair. If the water will take to drain out for draining out more than a month time, then the drainage conditions are very poor. And if the water is not get drained out completely, if some rainfall is there and water has been remained for a longer time, 1 month, 2 month, 3 month, whatever it may be, more than that, then the drainage conditions are extremely poor. Okay. So that part we have discussed in our previous lecture. Why we require the camber and what is the purpose of this particular camber, or we called it as a cross slope. Okay. The next purpose we have gone through, that is to prevent the stripping of the bitumen from the aggregates. Okay. Now this cross slope will help us to prevent the stripping. Now what is this particular concept? Once again, I am going to remind for everyone. Stripping is nothing but when you are going to add hot bitumen, always we are going to add a hot bitumen and coarse aggregate with each other. Okay. Do you know the process how this going to be mixed with each other in a rotary kiln or at any hot mix plant? Have you visited before this? You can put it in the chat box, or if you are having any queries regarding this. But once again, I am going to share with everyone. See, in our hot mix plant, our coarse aggregate are going to heat at a temperature of 160 to 170 degree. Please remember, our coarse aggregates are going to be heated at a temperature of 160 to 170 degree, and our bitumen, whatever the bitumen is there, it is going to be heated at a temperature of 135 to 140 or 45 degrees. Okay, so there is a gap of 15 degrees between the temperature of the coarse aggregate and between the temperature of the bitumen. Okay, and at such a high temperature, we are going to mix that two materials, that is your bitumen and your coarse aggregate, with each other. Okay, why this is required? Because this is required to make a proper bonding of the coarse aggregate with respect with your bitumen. Okay, each and every particle of the coarse aggregate will be coated, nicely coated with the thin bituminous layer. That is what our primary aim is. Okay, that is what we require. So for doing so, we are mixing that two ingredients at this particular temperature. So stripping is what? Stripping is nothing but removal of the bituminous layer, the removal of the bitumen over the coarse aggregate surface. Whatever the surface of the coarse aggregate, the bitumen is just get removed out. म्हणजे तुम्हाला फक्त खडी दिसते तिथे. डांबर जे कवरिंग होतं डांबराचं, ते डांबराचं कवरिंग निघून जातं. ठीक आहे. व्हाय दिस स्ट्रिपिंग इज गोइंग टू हॅपन अँड हाऊ दिस स्ट्रिपिंग इज गोइंग टू बी चेक्ड? दिस स्ट्रिपिंग इज इट मे बी हॅपन ड्यू टू द इम्प्रॉपर मिक्स. व्हॉट एव्हर द मिक्सिंग इज डन, वी आर हॅव्हिंग इन प्रॉपर ऑर इनकरेक्ट प्रोपोर्शन फॉर दॅट पर्टिक्युलर मिक्सिंग. सेकंड रिझन, बॅड क्वालिटी ऑफ द मटेरियल्स. ओके, इट मे बी युअर कोर्स ऍग्रिगेट ऑर इट मे बी युअर बिटुमिन ऑल्सो. ओके, so these two reasons mainly lead to the stripping of the bitumen. If you want to check this, how much stripping is going to occur, it has been there in your unit number 4, but still I can explain you how it has been there, how we are going to check the stripping nature of the bitumen. It is very simple. Just we have to take a material, that is bituminous material, we called it as bituminous concrete, that is mixture of your coarse aggregate and bitumen, which are finely mixed, which are properly mixed with each other. Okay, you go to any road surface, previously any road surface, and dig out the top structure, top surface dressing layer of that particular pavement. Road varti ja ani tya road cha ek varcha bhag jo asto jala surface dressing asa mhatla jata, kiwa top wearing course jala mhatla jata, tumhi to wearing course tumhi cut kara chhota sa part. Then whatever the material you are going to take, weight to the correct of correct value of 500 grams. How much bitumen we are going to take? Around 500 grams bitumen, or 100 gram bitumen also you can take. It depends on the size of that machine. So maybe a sample, that is 100 gram of sample you can take, and you have to put that sample in the stripping bituminous stripping apparatus. Okay, we are having the stripping value apparatus for the bitumen. In that we have to pour that particular sample. That same apparatus is not some specialized apparatus, just what it is like a oven. Tumcha ghara madhe jo oven asto na tasa asto, and in which you are going to heat the water. Pani asto, pani garam karto tyacha madhe. Ek oven like structure ahe, tyacha madhe pani takle jato. Thik aahe, ani he pani at a temperature heat kele jato. 10 degree, 20 degree, 30 degree, 40 degree, 50 degree, 60 degree. Thik aahe. So how much temperature we are going to maintain for the stripping? We are going to maintain a temperature of 60 degrees. Okay. So, pani tumhi 60 degree la maintain karta hai, garam karta hai. 60 degree la garam kelyanantar, you have already poured your bituminous sample, bituminous concrete in that. Okay. Tumhi tumcha sample adhi taklelo hota. After pouring the sample just for 1 hour or for 24 hours. Okay. Ek 24 tas tumhi sample theva. There is no one who will going to wait for 24 hours nowadays, but as per our IRC recommendation, we have to keep the sample in bituminous stripping value apparatus for 24 hours. So after 24 hours, what you are going to see, if there is low quality of bitumen which is being used, you are going to observe a thin layer over the water surface. Jasa पाण्यावरती तेलाचा तवंग जसा तुम्ही पाहिला असेल ना, एखादं तेल वगैरे पडल्यावरती, तसं त्या बिट्युमिनस लेअरचा असा एक थिन लेअर त्या वॉटर वरती तयार होतो. ठीक आहे. आणि खाली जे दिसते तुम्हाला खडी दिसते फक्त. मग आधीचं मास मला माहिती आहे, आधीचं मास किती होतं माझं 100 ग्रॅम्स. त्यानंतर हे स्ट्रिप आउट झालेलं मास 24 तासानंतर बघायचं ते मास किती आहे, ते मे बी 97-98 ग्रॅम भेटेल. मग हा जो डिफरन्स असेल तो पर्सेंटेज मध्ये कॅल्क्युलेट करायचा, किती पर्सेंट स्ट्रिपिंग झालंय, 1% 2% स्ट्रिपिंग झालंय. आय होप यू आर गेटिंग दिस. इफ यू आर हॅव्हिंग एनी डाऊट, इफ एनी वन इज हॅव्हिंग एनी डाऊट, वन्स अगेन आय एम रिपीटिंग द सेम थिंग, प्लीज यू कॅन आस्क मी, यू कॅन पुट इट इन द चॅट बॉक्स. ओके, सो दॅट इज वॉट स्ट्रिपिंग ऑफ बिटुमिन इज ऑल अबाउट. ओके, Then next is to prevent the slipping of the vehicles which are running at a higher speed. So as we have discussed in our previous discussion also, centrifugal force which is acting on us continuously. Okay, centrifugal force. But if your braking force, ekada kutra madhe aalay, if your braking force is more than that what your centrifugal force, then definitely there is slipping or skidding of the vehicle. Okay, so to avoid that, generally slipping is going to occur when we are having sharp horizontal curves or sharp vertical alignments, vertical curves. ठीक है, जिथे एकदम तीव्र वळण आहे अशा ठिकाणी तुम्हाला स्लिपिंगचा चांस राहतो. ठीक है, गाड़ी अचानक स्लिप होऊ शकते. सो इन दैट केस दिस कैम्बर और दिस क्रॉसलोप विल हेल्प अस. ओके, इन सम नाइस पिक्चर्स आई एम हैविंग, आई विल पुट यू इन आवर नेक्स्ट पीपीटीज, सम ऑफ द पीपीटीज. देन रेट ऑफ कैम्बर और द क्रॉसलोप इज यूज is usually designated by 1 in n or it may be expressed as a percentage. So 1 in 1, 1 is 2, 2, 1 in 2, 1.5, whatever it may be. Then the required camber of the pavement depends upon the pavement surface and the amount of rainfall. Okay, so whatever the pavement surface we are having, the required camber will always depend on the rainfall. That is the one important criteria, because we have three type major categories of the cambers. I think we have discussed that also. See this particular pictures. First is your parabolic camber, second one is straight line camber, and third one is combination of straight line and parabolic camber. Okay, so all this depends on the amount of rainfall which is going to be there. Okay, whatever the amount of rainfall which is going to be there, it will depend on this. The next part, whatever we have started, that is the what are the different values of the cambers that are recommended by the IRC, that is Indian Road Congress. So first, for cement concrete road, for heavy rainfall region, what is the size of camber that you are going to provide? It is 1 in 50 or 2%. Okay, generally in our day-to-day construction also, for rigid pavement we are going to provide a camber of 2 to 2.5% max. For rigid pavements, that is concrete pavements, we are talking about. In low rainfall region, we can provide in 1 in 60 or 1 in 1.7, that is 1.7%. Now, I can give you the best example. Recently, we have completed, means I am one of the part of associated with that, that is pavement which is constructed at our central bus stand, Pandharpur bus stand. Okay. So at that Pandharpur bus stand, they have provided the camber of around 2.5%. Okay, but the new Pandharpur bus stand, now concrete pavement is constructed na? So there they have provided around 2.5% of the cross slope. Okay, at different at various points, so that water will not get locked over that particular pavement surface. Then for thin bituminous surface, that is our flexible pavement, 1 in 40, that is 2.5%, or in low rainfall regions we can go for the 2%. Okay, then for waterbound macadam, that is your WBM roads which are totally prepared with the your coarse aggregate materials and murums and gravels, whatever in there. So generally we are having 3% of the cross slope which we are going to provide in case of heavy rainfall areas, and in case of low rainfall areas it is 2.5, and for urban road it is 4%. Why these values are get increasing? I think in the previous lecture I have discussed it. Correct? Why these values 2, 2.5, then 3, then 4%? Because these values are totally depend on the type of road surface. Okay, these values are totally dependent on the type of road surface. See, on the urban road, if I am going to provide a very flat surface, that is 1.7%, suppose a rate of camber is 1.5%, and it's urban road. Urban means 100%. There is no any kind of bitumen or there is no any kind of concrete on that particular surface. It's a purely made from the natural coarse aggregate or the whatever the subgrade soil or soil which is present over there. It is roller. It is rolled and compacted. Okay. But if it's a flat surface, it's having very low rate of camber or cross slope, then water will remain sustain on that particular tracks for a longer time. Okay, for a longer time. So that for the urban roads, our main aim is to drain out the water as early as possible. Our ultimate aim for the cross slope is to drain out the water as early as possible. Okay, so that this particular sizes of the camber will vary with respect to the type of the road surface. This is the technical result. Please remember this. So I hope we are up to this particular point in our previous lecture, and we were heading towards our next point, that is median or the traffic separator. Okay, median or the traffic separator. Now, what is median or the traffic separator? Anyone? Median or the traffic separators are nothing but intended to divide the traffic which is moving in the opposite direction. Their basic purpose of these particular traffic separators is to divide the traffic which is moving in the opposite direction. The main functions of the median is to prevent the head-on collision between the vehicles which is moving in the opposite directions on the adjacent lanes. As I said earlier, if we are having a 2-lane or 6-lane, 4-lane road, if we are having a single lane road, then there is a chance of head on collision. Head on means somor dhadaka. Okay, these words you can you have to remember, because these are technical words which are used in our traffic engineering field. Head on collision means somor che dhadak, and rear end collision means pathi magun yun dhadakla hai. Okay, रेअर एंड कोलिजन आणि हेड ऑन म्हणजे समोरची धडक. ठीक आहे, आपल्याकडे खूप सारे ऍक्सिडेंट असेच होतात. दोनच कॅटेगरीमध्ये एक होतात, एक तर हेड ऑन होतात किंवा मग रेअर एंड कोलिजन होतात, आणि तिसरी कॅटेगरी असते परपेंडिक्युलर डायरेक्शन मध्ये. ठीक आहे, ती दाखवतो मी तुम्हाला कशा पद्धतीने असते ती. सो मेन फंक्शन ऑफ आवर सेपरेटर इज टू प्रिव्हेंट द हेड ऑन कोलिजन्स बिटवीन द व्हेकल्स. देन ट्राफिक सेपरेटर्स मे बी यूज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द पेव्हमेंट मार्किंग्स, फिजिकल डिवायडर्स, or the area separators. Okay, or the area separators. So this is what about the traffic mediators. So if you are going to see, it's a 3-lane pavement. So this is the footpath, curve is been provided. Okay, because footpath and our pavement surface, that is our carriageway, is not going to remain on the same level. Okay, always remember, this will not remain on the same level. These are always on the two different levels. So there is rising portion which is being provided on the road surface, we called it as a curb. काय म्हटलं जातं त्याला? कर्ब असं म्हटलं जातं, की जो उंच भाग असतो. ठीक आहे, and this is nothing but after your pavement you are having the traffic separators. Now the width of pavements for the roads standardized by the Indian Road Congress, that is IRC. So if you are dealing with the expressways, width of medians or the separators, see, desirable width is 15 meter, okay, and minimum width is 10 meters. Then for the other highways, okay, other highways which includes your national or state highways, desirable width is 5 meters and minimum width is 3 meters. Then at intersection of the urban roads, म्हणजे जिथे तुमचा चौक असतो, at that particular point the width of the medians is 5 meters and minimum width is 1.2 meters, and on the long bridges again 1.2 meters. Okay, now all whatever this particular dimensions which have been present for expressways, you can going to see this minimum width of 10 meter width is there. Now if you are going to take our Pune Solapur expressway, okay, it's a national highway, Pune Solapur national highway number which is joining Pune and Solapur. But if you are going to see the width of the mediator, that width is around 1.2 to 1.5 meter max to max. At some point, I am just telling. At another point, it is up to 3 meter. At some point, there is just, we called it as a separators. Okay. Whose height is, that concrete blocks we are going to use, whose height is 39 centimeter around height is there. And they are just going to divide that particular track. Okay, so these are the desirable or the minimum widths. But this again, width of the medians will, one can change with respect to the site conditions. Please remember. Okay, one can change with respect to the site conditions. Whatever the site conditions we are having. Otherwise, you said no, sir. Expressway and desirable width is 15 meter. Okay, we are having some of the expressways. Whose width is very less, width of the median is very less. Okay, you can see the Pune Mumbai expressway, the minimum width of the median is around 8 to 10 meters. Now I don't think it is 15 meter exactly at any point, okay, but it is less than 10 meter also at some points. So it will again depend on the site conditions. Always remember, in our construction sector, it may be you are dealing with the road or you are dealing with the buildings, our actual site conditions are very much affecting the material as well as the dimensions and the drawings, whatever we are having. Okay, technical part that I want to suggest you. Okay, so please remember this. Otherwise, I am going to share. I have already shared this my YouTube videos. I have shared the study link for this particular videos, as well as if somebody wants the PPTs also, I will share all the PPTs, whatever PPT is with me, at the end of this particular unit. Okay, so I hope this part is get clear. See this one example of the medium. Now you can imagine by picture, looking at the picture also, whether this width is 10 meter or 3 meter, it is around max to max 2 meters. Okay, see, if you are going to see, it's a 4-lane road. If you are going to see this is one vehicle and this is another vehicle. Please look at my cursor. Okay, so here is one lane, here is another lane, two lanes, and on the other side two lanes. So 2 plus 2, 4 lanes. So basically it may be a national or it's a state highway. Okay, and you can see the width of the median. I don't think this width of median is going to exceed more than 2 meter at any cost. Okay, it is less than that. So always this median's width, we have to consider the site condition also. Okay, that is what I want to tell you. The next is curves. Okay, now what are the curves? What are the curves? Now, this particular curves indicates the boundary between the pavement and the median. Please remember what I want to tell you. This curves indicates the boundary between the pavement and the median, or a footpath or a shoulder. Okay, so the boundary which has been there between your carriageway and the footpath, or your carriageway and the shoulder, or your carriageway and your median. So whatever the boundary between these, we called it as a curve. Why this curve has been provided? This, again I am going to repeat, this curve is been provided just to separate out your carriageway and your footpath. Our footpath and carriageway level will not remain same. तुम्ही असं कधी बघितलं का, रोड वरती तुम्ही एखाद्या मेन रोड वरती चालताय, लगेच तुम्ही फुटपाथ वरती चालताय, शेजारी ऍडजस्टंटच आहे फुटपाथ, काय उंच भाग, एक उंची, कुठल्याही प्रकारची उंची प्रोव्हाइड केलेली नाही, असं पाहिले का? नाही, असं कधीच होत नाही. फुटपाथ जर बघताल, रोड सर्फेस पासून एका स्पेसिफिक उंचीवरती असतो, बरोबर आहे. मग हा जी हा जो उंच भाग प्रोव्हाइड केलेला असतो, जो एखादा कॉन्क्रीट किंवा स्टोन ब्लॉक्स ने तो फुटपाथ क्रिएट केलेला असतो, ठीक आहे, ती जी उंची दिलेली असते, ती जी बाउंड्री असते बिटवीन युअर पेवमेंट अँड युअर मीडियन और युअर फुटपाथ, दॅट बाउंड्री ओर दॅट रेस्ट पोर्शन, हाय राईज रेस्ट पोर्शन, ओके, दॅट पोर्शन वी कॉल्ड इट ॲज अ कर्व. आय होप नाव इट इज क्लिअर टू एव्हरी वन. ओके, नाव कर्व्स मेनली डिवायडेड इन टू द थ्री ग्रुप्स बेस्ड ऑन देअर फंक्शन्स. ओके, कर्व्स मेनली डिवायडेड इन टू द थ्री ग्रुप्स based on their function. First is low curve, second is semi-barrier type, and third one is barrier type. Okay, low curve having the height of 10 cm, semi-barrier type having the height of 15 cm, and barrier type having the height of 20 cm. Very easy to remember these all three types, because the specialty of this type is nothing but their height, 10, 15, and 20 cm, okay, respectively. Now in the next slide I am having the picture of the curve. See this particular part. So this is your road surface and this is your footpath. Okay, correct, this is your road surface and this is your footpath, and see this raised portion. This raised portion we called it as a curve. This raised portion we called it as a curve. I hope now it is clear to everyone. If the height is up to 10 cm, then we called it as a low curve. If the height is up to 15 centimeter, we called it as a semi barrier, and if height is up to 20 centimeter, we called it as a barrier type of the curve. Okay. Basically, curve is based on this three categories. That is barrier, semi barrier, and your low barrier types. Then next is your road margins. Okay. Now, what is the purpose of this particular road margins? The various elements which are included in the road margins are your shoulder, then guardrail, then footpath, then driveway, cycle tracks, parking lane, and embankment slope. Okay, these are the your road margins, considerable road margins that you are going to consider always. Now, in this particular road margins also, we are going to study each and every element. I think shoulder we have discussed earlier, but still we are going to repeat. Okay, so the first part is the shoulder. Now, what is the maximum width of the shoulder which has been provided on a roadway? Now, width of shoulder, again, it will totally dependent on the whatever the type of road surface you are having, whether you are dealing with the national highway, whether you are dealing with the state highway, whether you are dealing with the major district road, or whether you are dealing with the village categories of the roads. So your shoulder width is always depending on it, and the minimum width of shoulder which is recommended, it is for any category of the road, it is up to 1.5 meters minimum. That is what I am going to say. Okay, minimum width of the shoulder, that should be up to that particular point. Just a minute, I will show you some digits which are associated with this shoulder part. Meanwhile, if you are having any doubt, you can ask me. You can put it in the chat box. I'm just having some pictures of the shoulder. Meanwhile, if you are having any doubt, you can ask me. You can put it in the chat box. Okay, I hope there is no doubt from anyone. You are not discussing, so I hope it is clear to everyone. So once again, what are the things that we are going to read? I am not getting right now a picture for this particular time. So for the shoulders, always remember, shoulders are provided along the road edges to serve on the emergency lane for the vehicle to be taken out for the pavement. Okay, so in case of the emergency, if your vehicle get damaged or any other emergency work is there, your vehicle is not working properly, so you need to park your vehicle aside. So for that purpose, you are going to use it. Use the part. We called it as a shoulder. Always remember, shoulder is not that particular part which is used for the moving of the vehicle. Okay, it is totally reserved for the parking of the vehicles in case of emergency situations. Our mindset is totally different. That is why we are facing the problem. But shoulder is totally reserved for the parking of vehicles only in emergency cases. If there is any fault in the vehicle, so you need to park your vehicle aside. Okay. And that portion which you are going to utilize for that same purpose is nothing but your shoulder. And the general width of the shoulder, that is the minimum width of the shoulder, which is recommended by our IRC. I will correct myself. That is 2.5 meters. That is the minimum width which we have to maintain for that particular shoulder. Then the surface of the shoulder should be rougher than the traffic lanes, so that the vehicles are discouraged to use the shoulder as a regular traffic lane. Okay, please remember, the surface of the shoulder is not equal or is not similar with our carriageway. It is somewhat roughened, or it may happen you are having a concrete road surface and shoulder surface is the fully compacted soil you are having. Okay, or some other material is there. Okay, generally whatever the natural material is there, now we are going to compact it. Okay, we are not going to separately pour a concrete on that and we are giving the name as shoulder. It is not going to happen. Okay, why? Because this, once again remember, the purpose of the shoulder is just to park your vehicle in case of your emergency conditions. Okay, my humble request to everyone, if our lecture ends over here, because only 1 minute and 40 seconds are left to conclude this lecture, please rejoin the lecture using the same link. Okay, whatever the link I have put on the group for joining this lecture, please rejoin immediately so that we can reduce our time for joining all the students, because that will consume our 5 minutes. Okay, and in our next lecture, again, I have to take your attendance, so that will take again 5 to 7 minutes for myself. So I doesn't want to lose our this important time for joining. So if our lecture discontinues, only 1 minute is remain now. So please rejoin the lecture using the same link. Okay, this is for your information. Then next part that you are going to consider is your guardrails. Now, where these guardrails are provided? Okay, have you seen the guardrails? Guardrails. The meaning itself define its terminology or its purpose. These guardrails are provided at the edge of the shoulder when the road is constructed to fill. When the road is constructed on the fill, prevent the vehicles from running off of the embankment. Okay, one more time I am going to clear it. Guardrails are provided at the edge of the shoulder when the road is constructed on fill to prevent the vehicles running off of the embankment. Okay, that means whenever our road is in embankment,